Hey guys, it's the Patient Huddler coming at you with another video. And today I want to talk with you guys about what is ultimately driving and increasing the value of our projects and which criteria we could put as premise to evaluate whether a project is good or not. But before we start, please keep in mind that I'm a crypto and NFT investor, but not a financial advisor. So please do your own research before you ape full retard in all the good projects that are out there. Now with that out of the way, let's get started. The main driver of value and ultimately of the price of our projects from when we start investing to the point where we want to go is scarcity. In my opinion, scarcity is king, but it's not the sole driver of a price, and it's not the only factor that is getting the project to its end goal. To make my point here for scarcity, I want to show you three different types of scarcity creators that are existing in very valuable projects. The first point here is a maximum supply of coins and tokens within the project that cannot be increased, and with the premise of decentralization to the extent that it cannot be changed afterwards. This is given in most of the top 100, top 200 projects, but not in all of them. The best example here for this first criteria is, in my opinion, Bitcoin, because it has a fixed supply known to almost everyone of 21 million Bitcoin total, of which some are lost already and some are yet to be mined. But in general, this is the fixed supply, and Bitcoin is very scarce because there's only those 21 million potentially out there to ever be traded or held. The second criteria, in my opinion, that we should look at when we evaluate a project is, are there token lockup mechanics like staking, for example? There are a lot of incentives in other projects for users to stake their tokens and gain something that is correlating or that is similar to dividends. If this is the case, it is necessary to look at how much and how long the tokens will be out of circulation and how much is already being staked and locked up, and even locked up for a longer time than the time horizon of the possible investment is. Good projects as an example here, for example, could be VeChain. If you want to become an economy or masternode, you have to lock up a certain amount of tokens to be able to generate Veto and or to be a validator in the proof of authority consensus mechanism. The third category, in my opinion, is token burn or token destruction mechanism, which is creating an increasing scarcity from an originally fixed supply. The importance is that the originally fixed supply is not going to go above the number that it was fixed to, but it can certainly shrink the number. A good example for this one would be the Ecomi burn mechanic, where the token is linked to purchases in the Vivi app in the store, but in the future also to other burn mechanics directly from the circulating supply. Another example would be Terra, which has announced a massive burn, and also Ethereum. A lot of Ethereum is being burned at the moment, and the reserves of Ethereum on exchanges is going down. So scarcity, as we can see, is king, but it's not the reason, the ultimate reason, why you should invest in a project. Scarcity is the driver of price and value, and it has some enabling factors. So let's have a quick look in the drivers of the scarcity and value. But before we do that, please give this video a like if you enjoy it, subscribe to my channel, and Let me know what you think about these value drivers and which projects you think are the most valuable at the moment in the comments below. It is not enough to build a meme coin with a token burn mechanic and a fixed supply and put it out there on an exchange to have the price increase. Okay, honestly, people are jumping to almost every meme coin at the moment, but this doesn't guarantee that you will have a significant increase on your investment in that coin just because it has a certain level of scarcity. So there are enabling factors to that. And the first one here on my list is a continuous belief and a strong community in the project. And this by itself is driven by the second factor, which is utility. And this is, in my opinion, the most important factor of all of them. If your token, if your project solves a real life problem and is or is about to be used in the real world, then it provides utility to a lot of people or entities. Because this is when people see that it provides and it solves a problem, they create a belief and they create a community around that project. We are seeing projects like VeChain and like Ecomi and also other projects out there with even meme coins with strong communities as a driver that is infusing power to exactly this scarcity mechanism. The third point on my list is longevity, because it's not enough to have a scarce project and it solves a real use case, but it's also very vulnerable to competition, for example, and someone could be around the corner and doing it better in 6 months and the token collapses 80-90% or goes to zero. So we need a project or a token that solves a real problem and has adoption already, and there is not or not much competition out there that could really beat them for a long, long time. This can be foreseeable if we read into use cases. Examples for this one would be Chainlink, which is the most used Oracle project out there and basically the blue chip here, and VeChain, which is basically without competition in the supply chain and logistics solutions. My next point and the last point here is branding. We see it in the stock market and in companies in the real world market. Branding and the brand values are an increasingly important factor of differentiating one project from another. And we have seen much success if companies focus on their branding. I think that the companies that are operating in the blockchain market are also then favorable if they have a good branding and a good storytelling for them, because it's necessary to attract and to be remembered for the user base of the real solution and also for the investors. The best example here, in my opinion, is Crypto.com. They have put so much effort into branding. They have their names on the jerseys of sports competitors in the UFC, I think. And they have renamed recently the Staples Center to Crypto.com Center or something. So they are putting a lot of money into it and it clearly works. The project, the token is going up. I think we should, when we analyze projects, keep in mind that we have these scarcity factors and we have these value infusing factors that are ultimately driving the scarcity to drive our price and our portfolio values up. But we should not forget that in order to get into projects early, not all of these premises have to be yet fulfilled, except the maximum supply. And with that, I will let you go for the day. Thank you very much for subscribing, commenting, liking, and supporting me all the time with the growth on my channel. I'm in the third week heading to 400 subscribers, and this would not be possible without all of you. A lot of people are still not subscribed, so please do me the favor, subscribe to my channel if you liked the video, and Wherever you are on the world, have yourselves a great day or morning or afternoon and enjoy, and see you in the next video.